I've been getting more than anything recently is to do an updated fitness routine. If you've been following my channel for a really long time, then you know that when I started making videos, I actually did mostly fitness videos. And at that point in my life, like, fitness was everything to me and I was like so focused on it. But now I'm doing YouTube and school and it's just like super crazy. So that's why I haven't done like a ton of fitness videos recently. But I figured I owe you guys an updated fitness routine. So I'm gonna be showing you like my favorite workouts, some ideas to like get motivated and things like that. And this is a collab with my friend Kinzie, aka Kinzie Taylor B. She is one of my favorite people on YouTube and honestly like one of the best friends I've made here. She is such a sweet girl. So I'm gonna link her down below if you wanna go check out her video. She's doing like a fitness related kind of video too. If you like this video and wanna see more fitness stuff, be sure to give this a thumbs up and comment down below and tell me something that motivates you to work out or get in shape. I'm gonna go ahead and start with the video. I hope you like it and let's go. Routine really starts with getting motivated, just because I feel like if you're not motivated, you're gonna have a really awful time working out. So I love going on Pinterest and Tumblr just to get like kind of fitness inspiration and then definitely like a lot of recipe ideas. So I feel like both of those websites are a good place to start with your fitness journey. The next thing I'm gonna go over are my workout essentials. So of course I need to have headphones and my phone. I like over-the-ear headphones like these just because then they don't fly out as easily when you're working out. I also created a Spotify playlist just for you guys with all of my favorite songs, so I'm gonna have that link down below if you wanna check it out and find some new music to listen to. My next essential is definitely water. This is kind of a no-brainer, but obviously you have to stay hydrated. Now, I love regular water, but if you need kind of something to motivate you and you don't like water, then I would suggest just cutting up some fruit and adding that into a water bottle. Just gives it kind of a nice flavor, and then you might have more of like an incentive to actually drink more water throughout the day. So if I'm gonna be working out outside, then I definitely need some sort of blanket or yoga mat, just because, I don't know, sometimes it can hurt your butt to sit on the ground. The next thing that I always have to have are some sort of like fun workout clothes, the brighter the better. These are my Nike Free Run Fly Nets. I get questions about them all the time. They're basically socks with a sole and I adore them. If I'm just doing like walking or nothing too high intensity, then I'll wear my Nike Roche Runs. Now I'm gonna show you how to DIY your own workout tee, because I know workout clothes can be kind of expensive. So all you have to do is go onto your computer and look up some sort of image you'd want on your shirt. I'm gonna link the one I use down below to make it easier for you guys if you want to make the same shirt. Then you're just gonna need a t-shirt and print and transfer paper. I got mine from Walmart. Now, the instructions are gonna depend on which transfer paper you pick up. Mine told me to mirror the image before printing it, which basically means I'm just reversing it. That way when you iron it on, it's gonna be facing forward. So that's all you have to do, and then you have a cool new workout shirt. So now that we've got music, water, and cute workout clothes, we can actually go ahead and get into the workout. The first thing I always do is warm up, whether this is just like speed walking, running, whatever, and then I stretch. You always want to make sure you're stretching on warm muscles and not cold muscles. That's very bad for you. So I'll stretch out my left and right leg. I'll do the splits if I'm feeling adventurous, and then I like doing these like kind of holding arm stretches. So now I'm going to show you some things you can do without any gym equipment. The first one are core sit-ups. Basically, you're doing a regular sit-up, holding your knees to your chest. Then you can hold that position for about 30 seconds to have kind of a good ab workout. These are called bicycle crunches, and basically you're gonna be taking your elbow to your opposite knee, and it's a great way to work your abs. These are called walking push-ups, and basically you're gonna walk with your hands and then do a push-up. It engages your core as well as working your arms, and it's a really great way to exercise basically everything. So next up we have mountain climbers, basically a variation on the push-up involving your legs, and when you reach your leg up, it's really going to engage your core and it's great for working your abs. A variation on what I just showed you earlier, the walking push-up, is to walk outwards, kind of like forward instead of side by side. Basically you're working the same areas, but it's good to just kind of mix things up. Also like doing high kicks. This is a great way to work out your legs and your core. Basically you're doing backwards lunge and then kicking forward, and that's going to work your legs and your abs. So lastly, I just have plank ups. They're kind of like a push-up, except you're doing a plank instead, and it's a great way to work your arms. As always, I'm gonna go ahead and show you guys the music I use in this video, and I hope you like it. Oh,
have any questions about anything, be sure to leave them down below, and we'll see you in the next one. Bye!